everyone, welcome back to my class. This is Ruman Ali. I hope you all are doing well. In today's class, I'm going to explain you the rest of the lesson, agriculture crops. In the previous class, I have explained you about the process called agriculture, that means growing crops is called as agriculture. And even we have discussed about certain agricultural equipment and also about the selection of seeds in our previous session. Now in today's session, I'm going to explain you about sustainable farming. What do you mean by the word sustainable? Sustainable is nothing but supportable, maintainable, and in a proper manner. So farming can be done in a supportable manner. That farming is called as sustainable farming. So here we are going to discuss a story of a farmer, and his name is Malesh. So Malesh is a farmer. He has 10 acres of land. How he has used this 10 acres of land in an appropriate manner, let us see. So out of this 10 acres, he used 5 acres of land to grow mulberry, and then half an acre of land he used to grow the crops like maize, and half an acre of land he used to cultivate ginger and turmeric as intracrops. And the 3 acres of land he used to grow green fodder, and remaining 1 acre of land he used to grow, to cultivate vegetables like brinjal and tomato, and also to cultivate or to grow the flowers like jasmine, marigold and roses. So in this way, 10 acres of land of Malesh is used by him to grow different crops. And in this way, he is doing a sustainable farming as he is growing different crops in his land. So when you see that he is growing mulberry and maize, ginger and turmeric, green fodder, flowers, vegetables, all these are the different crops that are grown by the farmer Malesh. And besides this, he also maintains a poultry farm and dairy farm, and even a pond in which the fishes are present. So in his poultry farm, he reared both broilers and layers. Layers are the hens that can be grown to obtain eggs, and broilers are the ones that are used to obtain meat. In such a way, he is getting both eggs and meats by rearing different hens in his poultry farm. And in the dairy farm, he is having many cows and buffaloes. All such animals are present in his dairy farm. And he is also maintaining a pond in which certain fishes are present. By doing all certain things, he is getting more and more income. So the cow, which are reared by him in his dairy farm, the waste products that he is getting from this dairy farm, he used that waste materials to produce manure, right? To make manure, he is using the waste products that he is getting from dairy farm. And the manure that he is spraying in his field, that manure is called as panchgavya. To make this panchgavya, he need cow's urine, cow dung, and cow's curd, ghee, and also cow's milk. So these are the 5 products of a cow that he used to make his manure called panchgavya. Besides these 5 products, he also need banana, coconut water and jaggery. So all these are the different products that are waste, but they can be used in making a manure called panchgavya. So to make panchgavya manure in the liquid form, we need to mix all these contents in a proper manner, and after this we can pour some amount of water to make it in a liquid form. After it becomes ready, this liquid form of manure can be spread into his fields to grow more and more amount of crops in a proper manner, and also to get more yield. So in this way, panchgavya is a type of manure that can be made by using cow's waste products and also by using other materials. Another manure is also present that helps to increase the crop yield, and that manure is Jeevamrut. To make this Jeevamrut, we need cow's urine, cow dung, pulses powder, water and jaggery. So by mixing all these materials, we can make a manure named Jeevamrut. So in this way, Malish, he is not spraying any chemical insecticides or biofertilizers. Instead, he is going for natural methods. Like he is preparing manure naturally. He is preparing biofertilizers naturally in order to spray into the fields. So by spraying biofertilizers and biopesticides, he is using natural biopesticides like neem oil, and he is also using some neem leaves or ash. These are the different things that helps the farmers to control the insects. So in such a way, natural insecticides has been used by the Malish in his fields. So in this way, he is using organic insecticides and organic fertilizers like Panchgavya and Jeevamrut. All these are the different organic fertilizers and insecticides that helps in making the soil fertile. And if the soil becomes fertile, then the crops which are grown into the soil, they can get increases and we can get more amount of the crops. The crop yield can get increases by using organic insecticides and organic fertilizers, and also by using naturally prepared manures like Panchgavya and Jeevamrut. In such a way, doing agricultural practices, besides, he is also maintaining a poultry farm, dairy farm, and also a pond in which the fishes are reared. So by doing this, he is using the waste materials in order to increase the fertility of the soil. So all these kind of activities helps Malish to increase his income, and as the income gets increases, he can provide employment to others also. So this is what we call as sustainable farming. Sustainable farming is nothing but supportable, maintainable farming, where one should get benefit and even one can increase the yield, crop yield, by utilizing the natural organic fertilizers and organic pesticides. So this is how the sustainable farming can be done, by which one can get more amount of profit. Our next topic in this lesson is the success story of a woman farmer. Do you know who is Gangavar Manamma? She is a famous agriculturist. Not only men, women can also do agricultural practices. They can also become an agriculturist. So she is one of the famous agriculturists, and she belongs to a village, Gangavar, which is in Siddipet. So she faced a lot of problems in doing agricultural practices. She had 3 acres of land, which is of red soil. So red soil is found in this 3 acres of land. Now, when she used to grow certain crops in this land, it did not give much crop yield. Because of this, she faced a lot of problems. And when the rain comes, at that time only this soil becomes fertile. At that time only they can be able to grow some crops like jawar and millet, that too in a less quantity. So now she didn't know how to avoid this, how to come up with this problem. Then he met a society, that is Dakkan Development Society. This society is helping the poor farmers in order to riddle all of their problems. And this society is providing seeds to the farmers that can be grown in a well manner. They are providing biofertilizer so that the farmers should not use chemicals as a fertilizers. And even they were providing certain biopesticides in order to prevent the pests in their fields. After she met this society, she got an idea how to do the agricultural practices, how to do the crop rotation, everything. She got an idea, and then she made the soil fertile by using biofertilizers, like by pouring Panchgavya, which is a natural manure. So by pouring biofertilizers and Panchgavya in his field, in her field, She made it so fertile that she able to grow different crops here on this land. And that different crops include jawar, millets, pulses, cowpea, pigeon pea and many more. So these are the different crops that she has grown over her land. So in this way, she faced a lot of problems first. But after she met with the Deccan Development Society who contribute many things improving the agricultural practices, after she met the society, then she got how to do the agriculture by using natural methods, how to go for organic method to grow different crops. So by using organic methods, by applying organic fertilizers and pesticides, she can grow the crops well and she got benefit also. So what she did, she followed traditional method. That means she preserved some seeds that can be grown well, and this is a traditional method. And by using certain conventional method, she has grown that crops in a well mannered. Like this, she became a female agriculturist by applying conventional method in order to grow certain crops like jawar, millets, pulses, cowpea, pigeon pea and many more. Like Manima, many other people are also following conventional method in order to increase their crop yield and in order to grow the different crop. The story of a woman farmer who became a famous agriculturist by applying traditional and conventional method with the help of the suggestions that has been given by a society called Deccan Development Society. What do you mean by the word pesticides? Pesticides are the chemicals that can be used by the farmers in order to control the pests that are present in their fields. So basically, these are certain chemicals that can be harmful to the human beings and to the other living organisms. So if they are going to spray these chemicals in their fields, not only harmful insects, but the useful insects can also be killed by the application of these chemical pesticides. These chemical pesticides are poison one, not only for harmful insects, but also for the useful insects. This is not a good practice. And even by the application of chemical pesticides, these chemicals seep down into the ground. When they reach the soil, then it leads to soil and water pollution. The underground water also gets polluted when these chemicals enter into it. So in this way, application of chemical pesticides are showing adverse effect on the environment and it causes soil and water pollution. So instead of applying chemical pesticides, farmers, they can go for biopesticides. And biopesticides can be made by using different natural substances like green chilies, ginger, panchgavya and neem oil and other available materials. So these are the different natural materials that can be used to make biopesticide. By the application of these biopesticides, the farmers can control the pests that can be found in their fields. So instead of using chemicals that are very dangerous to us, they can go for biopesticide. If the farmers spray chemicals over the crops, then that crops can become poisonous and it leads to food poisoning. So if we have that fruits and vegetables which are coated with these chemicals, we can have the problems of food poisoning, and it also causes certain dreadful diseases like cancer. So to avoid all these different diseases, the farmers should not use chemical pesticides. They can go for biopesticides. Our next topic is kinds of crops. There are two kinds of crops. One is food crops and the other one is commercial or cash crops. Food crops are grown for the purpose of eating. That crops are called as food crops. Especially rice, wheat, jawar, pulses, oil seeds, vegetables and fruits. All these are called as food crops. But the crops that can be used, but the crops that can be sold and that are grown for commercial purposes, these type of crops are called as commercial or cash crops. And here we can take an example of cotton, jute and mirchi. The next topic is places where different crops grow in Telangana. So Telangana is a state and there are so many districts that are found in the state Telangana. Let us see in which districts the rice can be grown in a larger amount. So rice is a crop that can be grown in the districts like Karimnagar, Mehboobnagar, Nizamabad and Adilabad. And cotton is a crop which can be grown well in Nalgunda, Adilabad, Nagar Kurnool. And mirchi is a crop that can be grown well in Khammam and Mehboobnagar. And in Khammam, Jagtial and Rangareddy, you can see the trees like mango trees. And wheat plants can be grown well in Nizamabad, Nalgunda and Suryapet. And Siddipet, Rangareddy, Nagar Kurnool. These are the districts of our state Telangana in which we can see the crop plants like maize. So in this way, different crops can be grown in the different district of our state called Telangana. So here the lesson agriculture crops ends. In this lesson, we have seen how the natural methods, how the conventional and traditional methods helps the farmers to get profit, and by applying traditional method they can have a better crop yield. And we have also seen some of the agricultural equipments that can be used to carry out the different agricultural practices, and even we have seen the different types of crops that can be grown in the different districts of the state Telangana. Here the lesson ends. I'll be back with a new lesson in the next session. Meet you in next class. Thank you.